Americans who have had Moderna's COVID-19 vaccine are a big step closer to getting boosters. An FDA advisory panel recommended the extra shots today for senior citizens and those with health issues or at-risk jobs. The same guidelines already apply to Pfizer's booster shots. The recommendation now goes to the FDA and the CDC. Meanwhile, President Biden urged more businesses to mandate COVID vaccinations for their employees. At the White House, he said mandates are driving up the nation's vaccination rates. And he argued again, it's not about politics.
Vaccination requirements should not be another issue that divides us. That's why we continue to battle the misinformation that's out there.
The Biden administration plans to enact regulations with a vaccination requirement for larger companies, but some Republican governors are opposing the move. There is yet more data that shows U.S. inflation is running hot. The Labor Department reports wholesale prices spiked 8.6% in September from a year earlier. That is the most since 2010, when the government began calculating year-to-year increases. In Beirut, Lebanon, at least six people were killed and dozens wounded today in the worst Muslim-Christian fighting in years. Gun battles broke out as Shiite militants of Hezbollah protested against a judge investigating last year's Beirut port explosion. Many were shot by snipers on rooftops.
There were protests, and then suddenly gunfire began, shooting, RPGs, and everything. Why is it our fault? Isn't this a shame? They brought us back to the days of the Civil War.
That Civil War from 1975 to 1990 pitted Shiites against Christians. Police in Norway say that a bow and arrow rampage that left five people dead appears to be a terrorist attack. They have arrested a 37-year-old Danish man, but the motive is unclear. Flags flew at half-staff today in a small town near Oslo, where the attack took place last night. People left candles and stuffed animals as a memorial. At least 46 people died in southern Taiwan today when fire engulfed a residential and commercial building. Flames broke out in the early morning hours. The 13-story building was home to many elderly and poor residents, as well as those with disabilities. The cause of the fire is under investigation. Back in this country, it now appears that an oil spill off Southern California's coast this month was far smaller than first feared. The Coast Guard's new estimate today is that 25,000 gallons of crude was involved. The initial estimate was five times that amount. More than 10,000 John Deere workers went on strike today over pay and overtime rules. The walkout at 14 plants is the first major work stoppage at the farm machinery giant in more than 30 years. It comes after workers overwhelmingly voted against a tentative agreement. And on Wall Street, stocks rallied with major indexes rising 1.5% or more. The Dow Jones Industrial Average gained 534 points to close at 34,912. The NASDAQ added 251 points. The S&P 500 was up 74. Still to come on the NewsHour, another majority black city in Michigan faces health risks from lead-contaminated water. Thousands of workers in Hollywood threaten to go on strike, and studios could face a shutdown. Missouri becomes the latest state to expand access to Medicaid, plus much more.
This is the PBS NewsHour from WETA Studios in Washington, and in the West from the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State University.